بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. This is a description of the data show for the pancreas. This gland is compound tubuloalveolar gland present in the concavity of the second part of the duodenum. As any gland, it is formed of stroma and parenchyma. Stroma is formed of a capsule which is very thin, and the trabeculae which arise from the undersurface of the capsule, but they are also very thin trabeculae. And accordingly, the gland is divided into indistinct or ill-distinct lobes and lobules. So the lobule is not completely separated as you see here, as well as the lobes. In addition to the background of reticular networks stained by silver. The parenchyma is formed of exocrine part, formed of acini and ducts, as well as we have an endocrine part which secretes the insulin and glucagon. Here we have in the exocrine part, you can see the pancreatic acini, rosette shaped, and we have here a duct. It's a lumen of the duct, and the lining here is the cuboidal epithelium with central rounded nuclei. Here we have the pancreatic acini, which are serous acini with apical acidophilic zymogen granules and basophilic cytoplasm. This high power picture demonstrates the features of the serous acinus of the pancreas, where the acinus is lined by pyramidal cells that have apical acidophilic zymogen granules, basal basophilic cytoplasm, and the nucleus here is not central. It is rounded as a typical serous acinus, but it is basal in position. Here you can see that the boundaries are ill-defined. What is the cause of ill-defined boundaries? The cause of that is the presence of numerous intercellular canaliculi, so that the exact borders cannot be easily identified, exactly like that of the cells of the parotid acinus. This is a picture to demonstrate the nucleus of the centroacinar cell, which is the start of the intercalated duct. Here, because it is invaginated or telescoped inside the pancreatic acinus, you can see in the lumen the centroacinus or centroacinose cell. And these are the typical pyramidal cells with secretory acidophilic granules, zymogen granules at the apex, and the basal part tends to be basophilic, and the nucleus is rounded basal in position. In this picture, you can diagnose the difference between the secretory acinus of the parotid with that of the pancreas. Here, in case of the pancreas, we have the centroacinose cells, which are the start of the intercalated duct, but because it is telescoped, that's to say, it enters inside the lumen, it is showing the centroacinose cells. But in case of the parotid, we don't have centroacinose cells as the ducts are not telescoped or invaginated inside the acinus. That's to say, here the acinus and the duct here is telescoped inside the acinus. But in case of the parotid acinus, the duct will start here outside this lumen so that we don't have centroacinose cells. Another feature here, which is the absence of the myoepithelial cells. We don't have myoepithelial cells in the pancreas, but we have myoepithelial cells in the parotid. No need for the myoepithelial cells here because the duct is telescoped inside, so it's very easy to take the secretion. No need for myoepithelial cells. This is an EM picture or ultrastructure picture for ultrastructure features of the cells of the pancreatic acinus as well as the lumen. Here you can see the cell, this one, and this one, and this one, and so on. These cells in this picture are characterized by having apical, membrane-bound, electron-dense zymogen granules, which is typical for the serous cells. Here you have in the lumen of this serous acinus, you have centroacinose cells and nuclei. This is the cell and this is the cell. Here the boundaries, and this is the nucleus of this cell, and this is the nucleus of the neighboring cell. The presence of these cells in the lumen of this serous acinus denotes that it is a pancreatic acinus. Of course, you know other features as regards the ultrastructure picture or the EM picture of the pancreatic cells. What are these features? These features are the following. Here we have the cell of the pancreatic acinus, and this is the neighboring cell. Notice here that we have the following features. At the side walls, we have junctional complexes. And what is this? This is what is called intercellular canaliculus. And the presence of these intercellular canaliculi is the cause of the ill-defined boundaries in the light microscope. Because when the two cell membranes are very near to each other, you can see it by the light microscope. But when they are far away like this, due to the presence of intercellular canaliculus, the cell boundaries cannot be seen clearly. And this is the same feature in the serous acinus of the parotid. Here we have also what else? We have the supranuclear Golgi. And of course, the electron dense zymogen granules in the apex, and we have also a lot of mitochondria because it is secreting proteins, and we have the rough endoplasmic reticulum in a basal position, which is responsible for the basophilia at the base. So what are the features? Number one, secretory granules. Number two, supranuclear Golgi. Number three, a lot of mitochondria. Number four, the basal rough ER in abundant amount. Number two, three, four. Number five, the intercellular canaliculi. Number six, and finally, we have the junctional complex between adjacent cells to prevent the entry of the secretion to the wall of the pancreas. And if this occurs, this will be a condition called pancreatitis, which is fatal. Here it is a diagram demonstrating the features of protein secreting cells like that of the serous acinus in the pancreas as well as the parotid. Here the nucleus is active nucleus, achromatic with prominent nucleus. And here we have basal rough ER, and this is the cause of the basal basophilia. The mitochondria are very numerous, and they are characterized by being elongated mitochondria, like that seen also in the cytoplasm of the secretory or the striated or the intralobular duct. Here we have a well-developed supranuclear Golgi, and finally the secretory granules electron dense. This diagram demonstrates the differences in the duct system in the pancreas from the parotid. First difference is the telescoped intercalated duct forming centroacinose cells. The second difference is the absence of the intralobular, which is the striated duct. So we have intercalated, we have interlobular duct, then we have interlobar duct, then we have the main duct. We have only four ducts. You should remember the lining epithelium of each of these four ducts. This is a big picture for the pancreas under the low power. You can see clearly these patches, which are L-stained or pale-stained among the darkly stained tissue of the pancreas. Those are the islets of Langerhans, which represent the endocrine portion of the pancreas. Here we have a group of cells scattered, not forming acinus, and they are supplied inside by the fenestrated blood capillaries for the rapid taking of the hormones. This picture demonstrates the pancreatic acini with the basophilic part containing the nuclei and the apical granular acidophilic part with a narrow lumen. And here you can see this pale stained patch of the cells scattered around the fenestrated capillaries. This is the islet of Langerhans and these are the pancreatic acini. Here we have three principal cells in the islet. We have beta, alpha and delta cells. This is another picture demonstrating the islet of Langerhans, not capsulated. It formed of scattered cells and rich in the fenestrated blood capillaries. Here we have the pancreatic acini and the thin connective tissue septa here, separating the lobes from each other. And remember that this islet has a stroma formed of reticular fibers and reticular cells to support these cells, as well as the fenestrated capillaries in between. How to differentiate between the parotid and pancreas under the microscope? Here you can see clearly the presence of intralobular ducts. All these structures with wide lumen are intralobular ducts or striated ducts. Here you cannot see these ducts. These ducts are not present here. Again, we have thick connective tissue trabeculae, this one, and here we have thin connective tissue trabeculae. And accordingly, here the lobulation is very evident, is well demarcated, and here the lobulation is not so evident or it is ill-defined. This picture showing the pancreas on the right side and the parotid on the left side. You can see here clearly that we don't have striated ducts, and here we have the striated ducts, intralobular ducts inside the lobules. By high power, you can see the centroacinous cells inside the lumen of the acini of the pancreas, but they are absent here because the intercalated ducts are not telescoped. Here we have this islet, ill-defined patch or pale stained patch in a background of dark stained pancreatic tissue formed of scattered cells around fenestrated capillaries. This is the islet of Langerhans, but we don't have this islet in the patch. This is a low magnification of what? You have to look here. We cannot see the intralobular ducts, and we have here thin trabeculae and ill-defined lobulation. So this is the pancreas. The section is characterized by two things. Here, ill-defined lobulation and absence of the intralobular or the striated ducts. While we have secretory acini characteristic for the pancreas as well as other duct system in between the lobes and lobules. The second slide, the field shows the parenchyma of pancreas. Identify two components of the gland and the function of each. Two components, we have exocrine component, which is the represented by the pancreatic acini secreting the pancreatic juice containing different digestive enzymes like the amylase and the lipase. Here we have the second component, which is the endocrine part, formed by the islet of Langerhans secreting hormones like insulin and glucagon. This is to describe the histological structure of pancreatic acinus. This is the pancreatic acinus. What is the feature of this acinus? The acinus is small in diameter. The serous acini are always small in diameter with narrow lumen. So this is the feature of the acinus, small in diameter with a narrow lumen. And then the features of the acinar cells here, the cells are pyramidal with ill-defined boundaries, and they have apical acidophilic zymogen granules and basal rounded nucleus and basal basophilic cytoplasm. This is a very nice slide. In the shown section of the pancreas, the arrows point to the blood vessels. Here we have, these are the blood vessels lined by the flat squamous cells. These are actually capillaries. here in the connective tissue of the pancreas, and also the arrowheads here representing or pointing to centroacinose or centroacinar cells. In case of these arrows, which are different from these arrows, these are for the blood vessels, as we have said, but these arrows are representing the intercalated duct. And as we have said, this is the start of this duct, which is telescoped inside the acinus, which is called centroacinar cells. So this is the intercalated ducts, because they are lined by simple squamous epithelium. As you see, we have here flat nuclei. Identify the labels demonstrating the organelles in pancreatic acinar cell at the ultrastructural level, which means the EM pitch. Here we have this is the mitochondria, elongated mitochondria. These are the rough ER present at the base of the cell. This is achromatic nucleus. This is the nucleolus. This is the supranuclear Golgi here. And these are the zymogen granules, electron dense. Correlate between the LM and the EM features of the pancreatic acinar cell. Here, this is a light microscopic picture. You can see the apical acidophilic cytoplasm, granular cytoplasm, due to the presence of these zymogen granules. So these zymogen granules, which are electron dense here, they are responsible for the appearance of this granular upper part. Also, the nucleus here is vesicular with prominent nucleolus, because it is an achromatic nucleus with a lot of achromatin, and it has a prominent nucleolus. The cytoplasm shows basal basophilia because of the presence of a lot of rough ER at the base of the cell. If you are asked why the boundaries here are not evident, the cause of that is the presence of the intercellular canaliculi, which is an extension of the lumen between the two cells, so that the cell membranes here are not so evident. The field shows LM picture of a mixed gland. Identify the gland. It is the pancreas. Name the component outlined by the black circles. They are the islets of the Langerhans. List three major cell types in this component and their hormonal secretion. We have beta cell for insulin, alpha cell for glucagon, and delta cell or D cell for the somatostatin. You may be asked also in the exam about the percentage of each one. The alpha cell, 15%. The beta cell, 70%, while the delta cell is 10%. You may be asked also about the size of the cell. Her alpha cell, it is big, so it is 15 to 25 micrometer. While the beta cells, which is the most numerous, is smaller, 10 to 15 micrometer. And the delta cell represent 10%. But actually, it is located at the periphery of the cells with no comment on its size. Also, you may be asked about the location of the different cells. The beta cells in the center, the alpha cells and the delta cell are at the periphery.